In this video, I will show you how to use Skype on Android. I will start by showing you how to install. Then, we will create a new account and check all settings that we can use. After that, we will see how we can call somebody and share screen with them. Also, we will see how to start a conference call. For you to install Skype on an Android, you will need to find Google Play. Tap on Google Play. On the search above, write Skype. After you have found Skype, just tap on Install and wait. After the install is complete, just tap on Open. After you have installed the app, to create an account, you will need to do the following. Now, tap on Let's Go. Tap on Sign In or Create. Here, let's tap Create One. If you already have an account on Microsoft, you can use that to sign in. Here, you can use your phone number or email. Let's use for this demo an email. So I will tap Use your email instead. Write the email. Now tap Next. Create a new password. Now tap Next. Write your first name and last name. Tap Next. Get the code from your email app to verify the email. Let's go to the Gmail app to get this code. Here it is. Let's go back to the Skype app to write it. Tap Next. Write the CAPTCHA code. Tap Next. Now select the date of birth. Now select the country. Tap Next. Confirm your age by tapping Next. Here, you can find contacts easily. You can tap Allow or Deny, how you wish. Tap on Continue. I will tap Allow here. Here again, tap on Continue and press Allow to all dialogues from this step. Now, your Skype is connected on your Android phone with a new account. Let's see a short presentation of the app. On this new app, you will have on the top left a notification button, so tap on that when you have new notifications. On the right top, you have some sort options for the list that you will have with the chats. Also, you have on the bottom the following buttons: chat, call, contacts, and new chat button. You can check the settings and set up a status or a picture if you press on the top part, where is your profile. Let's tap it. Here, you can set up your current state. You can be active, busy, away, or invisible. If you are invisible, the person will not see that you are connected to Skype. After that is the status zone. Let's change our status. Also, here you have option for Skype profile. Here you can change your name, picture, share your profile and set up some option for privacy. Option other ways people can find you gives you control not to appear on the search when somebody searches your name. Here is this option. Also, you can add a mobile number here if you want. Now on settings, you have also a lot of options. Account and profile are almost the same option as Skype profile that we already looked on. On general, you have the option to change the language of the app. On appearance, you can choose the theme for your Skype and also the main color. You can play with it and set up it how you like. On calling settings, you have some interesting stuff, like caller ID. You can make so when a person receives a phone call from Skype to look like it's coming from your phone number. Also, you can allow only calls from contacts to ring on this device. This way, you will not be bothered by anyone that you do not know. Also, you can activate the option Call Subtitles. This will be very good for people who do not hear well. On messaging, you have options specific to messages. Nothing special, but this is useful. On notifications, you can set up what exact push notification to receive. Skype is generous and lets you exactly choose what you wish to receive. That is very nice. Also here, if you tap on the chat notification, you will be able to disable notification for some time or permanent. Now the last option is contacts. Here you can sync your phone contacts with Skype if you have not already done this. So now you have Skype installed on your phone. Skype is a very good app to keep in touch with friends and coworkers. To add a contact on Skype, you will need to do the following. Tap on the contact button from the bottom. Here, tap on the icon from the bottom with a profile and a plus. On the search, you will need to add the username of the account you want to add or the name for that person. Let's search a part of a username. How you can see, Skype found multiple accounts with the same name. So, when you add a contact, check the username of the person, and also is good to check the image. If there are multiple persons with the same name, the best way to choose who is your contact is to look at the picture. Now tap on Add for the person who you want to add as a contact. The person who you added as a contact need to confirm that they know you. So, wait for the other person to respond. If you want to call somebody on Skype, please follow these steps. First, on the chat zone, if you already talked with that person, you can easily start call. If you do not find the person on this zone, tap on the contacts and find the person there and tap on it. Tap on the person who you want to call. Now, on the top, you have two buttons, a video icon and a call icon. If you wish to start a video call, just tap the video icon. If you want to start an audio call, just tap the phone icon. So let's tap on the video call. Now the call is in progress and we are waiting for the other person to accept the call. Please note, if the person has accepted the call, you can easily turn on or off video or audio in any time of the call. On this window, you will have three buttons: microphone, video, and end call. Also, you'll have on this window three dots on the bottom. Tap on it. Here you will see other options like allow incoming video, turn subtitles on, add people, start recording, and share screen. If you turn subtitles on, then Skype will try to write what the person said. This is a very good option for those who do not hear well. Also, if you want to keep a copy of the discussion with the person, you can press on start recording. Please keep in mind that both of you will get the record, so be sure to tell the other person you record the meeting. Also, you can share your screen for the person if you need to show them something from your phone. these are the main options of the call. If you wish to create a conference call in Skype, please follow these steps. You have two options to start a conference call. Let's see what you can do if you already are in a call with somebody and you want to add another person to the call. So I will just go start a call with somebody. I'll tap the person's name, tap the call button. So the call has started. Now, tap the three dots from the bottom right. Tap Add People from this menu. From the list, select what person you wish to add to a conference. It could be multiple persons. If you have a big list, you can easily search the contact. Tap on that person to check that you wish to add on the conference call. If you added by mistake somebody, you can easily delete them before you call them. Tap the X button near their profile picture. After you have added the person you want, tap on Add. Now the persons will be called, and after they accept, you will start the conference call. Another way to start a conference call is to create a group for that conference. Tap on this button from the bottom. Now, tap on the new group chat. On this group, write the name of the conference you want. After this, select the person who you wish to add in a group. After you have done this, just tap Done. In this new group, just tap on the call from the top and you will start your new conference. Like the simple call, on conference call, you have the same options to add more persons, share screen and record meeting. This is quite useful. For you to start a share screen, you will need to call somebody. Let's call somebody from my list. Tap on that person's name and tap the call button from the top. The call has started. Now, tap on the three dots from the bottom left. Here, you will see the screen sharing option. Tap Share Screen. Now, you will receive a notification about exposing sensitive info. This info could be different depending on the Android version and your brand of phone. If you are sure to start the screen sharing, tap on Start Now. Now screen sharing is started. Let's see how this looks on somebody else's screen. Here is the other account connected to the call. You will see that this person sees your current screen. Any notification, any data is visible to that person. The screen sharing has a bit of a lag, but that's normal. See a bit how it behaves. To stop the share screen, just go back to the Skype app. You will have on the top a stop screen button. Tap on it and the screen sharing should stop. If this was useful, please like, share and subscribe. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them on the comments area below.